Most people are more likely to associate Colorado with tall rocky mountains rather than tornadoes. Between 1952 and 2010, Weld County, Colorado reported more tornadoes than any other county in the states. For those used to chasing in Texas or Oklahoma, hunting tornadoes in Colorado can seem like a different game. I've experienced a lot of frustration trying to capture tornadoes here. Year after year, the setups I'd choose to chase turned out to be duds. And then, the one or two anemic days I'd take off would produce some of the most photogenic storms anyone has ever seen. It wasn't until 2016 that I finally broke my Colorado curse. For this video, we're going to focus on this weird tornado hotspot in eastern Colorado and adjacent areas. Why is it that tornadoes seem to magically occur here? Mid-level westerly winds crossing higher terrain subsides and warms when it comes down the leeward side of mountains. This often leads to the formation of a cyclone in a process called Lee Cyclogenesis. The taller the mountains, the stronger the cyclone tends to be. And guess where the tallest mountains in the lower 48 are located? A Lee cyclone often sets the stage for stormy weather. Several other fascinating ways. The topography of Colorado can enhance thunderstorm and tornado development. Thunderstorms tend to get an earlier start in Colorado as moisture-rich air runs into mountains and is forced up. Once upslope storms develop, they tend to take their sweet time organizing into supercells, if they do at all. In the right environment, these storms can organize into supercells as mean as any.
It's the other side. Power line's down.
Smaller scale terrain features like the Palmer Ridge also help the Rockies channel winds into localized swirls and zones of convergence. When a Denver cyclone and or a DCVZ forms during unstable conditions, the chance of a tornado increases significantly. But generally, these are weaker, non-mesocyclonic tornadoes, more commonly known as landspouts. Landspouts lean toward the weaker side of the EF scale. Still, not a good time to get caught in the outhouse. When forecasting tornadoes around Dallas or Oklahoma City, I generally like to see dew points in the 60s or higher. Anything lower than that, I call doo-doo points. But pressure is critical when considering dew points. As terrain gets higher in elevation, the air gets thinner, right? The pressure drops. So a doo-doo point of 52 in Dallas doesn't mean the same thing around Denver. Chasers know when forecasting tornadoes in Colorado, dew points in the 50s often gets the job done. Since 1950 to date, there have only been 3 fatalities from Colorado tornadoes. One reason, in case you haven't noticed, eastern Colorado isn't exactly a teeming metropolis. But you have to admit, it has a certain charm.
Look out! Come on.
Move them on, cut them out. Ride them in. You guys are almost as bad as the storm chasers.
Road conditions here can get sloppy fast, and options can get slim. I often find myself chasing through parts I'm not exactly sure I belong in.
Going on, ducks. Man, these roads have killed me again.
Positioning underneath a mesocyclone to get up close dramatic footage can be more difficult out here. But the closer shot isn't always the best shot. Would you rather be watching this tornado from here or here? Once you understand Lee cyclogenesis, the upslope regime, and many of the mesoscale features that can enhance lift, convergence, and vorticity, you'll understand these Colorado tornadoes aren't magic at all, just physics. Forecasting the co-location of these features far enough in advance to have time to drive across the country and chase them in the first place can be a challenge and often boils down to a coin toss.
Like so many other things in life, if you lose the coin toss, you just gotta flip again. And keep on flipping. And try not to flip out.
Till next time, friends. Happy trails.